The city of Varazdin is located in the north of Croatia, close to the borders with Slovenia and Hungary, roughly 80 kilometers from the Croatian capital Zagreb. The town boasts some magnificent historic buildings and a castle. The gorgeous old center has countless Baroque buildings, making it a popular destination for city trips in Croatia. Varazdin is home to some 40,000 people in the northern part of Croatia. Apart from the historic center, Varazdin hosts many cultural festivals, sports clubs, and is also home to two faculties of the University of Zagreb. It all adds to the relative peace and quiet and relaxed ambiance of this gorgeous city, which is also sometimes called Little Vienna. That's of course no surprise, as it has been part of the Austro-Hungarian Empire for a long period in its history. Among the many festivals and activities in the city is the Croatian International Airshow Varazdin, held at the recreational airport a mere 2 kilometers outside the city. The 2015 show celebrated the 85th anniversary of Aeroclub Varazdin. The airfield is mainly used by sports aircraft on sightseeing flights or for agricultural purposes and is home to Diamond Aircraft Croatia, a service center and parts manufacturer for this popular brand of sports aircraft. No doubt because of the favorable location at the intersection of three countries. Thousands of people came to watch the show from the showground on both Saturday and Sunday afternoon, attracted by the varied program and scorching hot weather. While the crowd area was quite small, it had all the usual amenities, including a large catering area where people could also get some shelter from the blistering sun. There were also some traders and promotional stands. Children's entertainment, which included an out-of-service sports plane they could crawl all over, and a virtual reality flight simulator. The static included most of the display participants and a few visiting aircraft, including this Saab Zafir from Austria. With a manufacturing unit for wings parts of Austrian company Diamond Aircraft at Varazdin, it's only fitting a Diamond aircraft should open the flying display. The DA-20 Katana is a twin-seat, single-engine aircraft that started out as a recreational aircraft design. While the DA-20 makes its way to the runway, the next act prepares to fly his display. The DA-20 first flew in 1991 and gained certification in 1993. The aircraft has excellent glide characteristics, also thanks to its light weight, owing to the extensive use of composite materials. There is also a military training variant of this aircraft in Ecuador and Poland. Next up was a Croatian Extra 300, as indicated by the registration number 9A, followed by the suffix TWI. Combined with the small print behind this registration, it reads Twister, and this aerobatics display is flown by Branimir Ambrekovic from Zagreb, the only Croatian civilian pilot licensed to fly aerobatic flights. He is 49 years old and has been flying aerobatics since he was around 30. He works for a telecommunications company by day, so aerobatics are a hobby that quite literally spun out of control. He has taken part in aerobatics competitions, including the FAI World Championship and the Dubai Air Exhibition. The Extra 300 is a German-built aerobatics aircraft from the factory of Walter Extra. It can take up to plus or minus 10 G, roll at 450 degrees per second and go as fast as 410 kilometers per hour. If you would like to find out what that feels like, you can fly from Zadar at the Croatian coast with Branimir Ambrekovic in his extra 300. Next up was an EC-135, formerly of Eurocopter, now Airbus Helicopters. This one belongs to the Croatian police, which is part of the Croatian Ministry of Interior Affairs. The first of two EC-135s was delivered to the Croatian police in 2013. The first one was built for the Spanish Guardia Civil, though for a variety of reasons they never took delivery of it. It was stored unused for 4 years until it was bought by Croatia. This helicopter is the second EC-135B2+, on the strength of the Croatian police forces. There it joined the other helicopter types in use by the Croatian police, the Bell 206 and the Augusta Bell AB212. The EC-135B2+ variant of the Croatian police is currently mainly used for transport and training, but can also provide limited medical emergency support thanks to the defibrillator equipment on board. Croatia recently closed a deal with German company ESG to install specialized surveillance equipment so the helicopter can also perform observation tasks at day or at night. This is the Pegasus EDA 100 Flamingo, an ultralight aircraft made mostly of composites, built in Branik in Slovenia, even if the registration of this prototype is Italian. The aircraft was first presented to the general public at the Airshow of Friedrichshafen in Germany in 2010. It is a two-seater with a fixed landing gear, though the option exists for a retractable gear. The aircraft is still in testing and it is expected to cost around €85,000 per plane. It has a cruising speed of 260 km per hour with fixed gear and 310 with retractable gear. We stay in Slovenia with this Soko G2 Galeb, a jet trainer built in the former Yugoslavia and, as you can see, still carrying a Serbian registration. This particular aircraft is now operated by Aquila Air Adventures, a company located at the grass strip at Ajdovščina in Slovenia, which offers jet experience flights on G2 Galeb trainers, underlining the grass field capabilities of the aircraft in the process. This demonstration is flown by Slovenian Andrej Perč. On Sunday, a second G2 of Aquila Air Adventures was present in an all black paint scheme. The G2 first flew in 1961 and was intended as the replacement of the T-33 trainer with the then Yugoslav Air Force. Apart from Yugoslavia, Libya was also a prime user with 116 aircraft delivered, of which at least 4 are still operational with the Free Libyan Air Force. For more information on how you can fly with Aquila Air Adventures, simply check out the website at aquilaairadventures.weebly.com. The University of Zagreb has a faculty of traffic sciences. This encompasses several forms of traffic, including water, city traffic, road traffic, and, as you can see with the next act at the show, air traffic. In the field of aeronautical science, students acquire knowledge and skills to use organization and control of the process of air transport. The fleet of this faculty consists of several aircraft types, including the Piper PA-44 and Cessna 172 you see here, but also a Diamond DV-20. Media were out in force and had plenty of attention for Petr Pondonček here and the pilots of Krila Uluje, which we'll see in action later on. Petr Pondonček is a Slovenian aerobatic star, and at Varazdin he performed in his Extra 330 SC, an even more potent aerobatics aircraft from the Extra series of airplanes than the Extra 300 we saw earlier. Peter earned his license to fly gliders at 16, began flying motorized planes at 21, and aerobatics at age 24. He has won the Slovenian National Championship 8 times and represented Slovenia in the World and European Championships. At age 44, he joined the Challenger class of the Red Bull Air Race in 2014, and in 2016 he will take part in the Red Bull Air Race Masterclass. In the Masterclass, he will not be flying this Extra 330, but a newly acquired Edge 540 V2. Thank you. and after landing, Peter puts on a show on the ground. The first display team of the day was making its debut in Croatia, the Latvian Baltic Bees, flying 6 L-39 Albatross jet trainers for the first year, an increase of 1 from the 5 jets they flew before. The L-39 is a Czech-built jet trainer, produced by Aero Dohody. For years it was a standard jet trainer in the Warsaw Pact, but it is being replaced with most Eastern European air forces nowadays. The Baltic Bees are a civilian display team with all ex-military pilots, except for the leader, who is the only true civilian pilot on the team. They were established in 2008 and their home airfield is Jūrmala in Latvia, but they display all over Europe and the Middle East throughout the summer. On to the military part of the flying display then, starting with the Slovenian Air Force PC-9M Hodurnik, flown by First Lieutenant Andrej Fiorel. The Slovenian Air Force operates 11 PC-9Ms as light attack aircraft, as you can tell from the underwing racks. All Slovenian PC-9s have been upgraded by the Israeli company Radom Aviation. For the training role you would expect the PC-9 to be used for, the Slovenian Air Force uses the Czech-built Zlin 242. All Slovenian PC-9s are based at Cerkel ob Krki Air Base. Another Croatian neighbor sent its fighter aircraft to Varazdin for a roll demonstration, rather than a full aerobatic demo, though the difference between the two in this case is a bit fuzzy. This is the Hungarian Air Force's Saab JAS-39C Gripen. Swedish aircraft manufacturer Saab is hoping to export the Gripen to Croatia to replace the MiG-21 from 2020, if the decision to replace the MiG-21s is made by the end of 2016 at least. Gripen entered Hungarian service in 2007, where it replaced the MiG-29. 11 single-seaters and one two-seater are based at the 59th Hungarian Air Force Base at Kecskemét, where they form Puma Squadron, a full member of the NATO Tiger Association. Earlier in 2015, there was quite an upset when all pilots of the Croatian Air Force display team resigned from the Air Force at the same time. Soon afterwards, the Air Force decided to re-establish the team with a new group of pilots, led by Colonel Damir Barezic, team leader from 2009 until 2012. The team's commentary at Varazdin came from Krila Oluja No. 6, Captain Zvonimir Mranovac, who joined the team a few weeks later as full display pilot. That meant the team performed with 5 PC-9s at Varazdin. The PC-9 is a standard training aircraft at the Air Force Academy at Zadar on the attractive Croatian Adriatic coast. Here, Colonel Damir Barzic calls the break, with the PC-9 solo display pilot of the 2014 season, Captain Ivan Andic on his left wing as number 2, and First Lieutenant Goran Gurgic on his right wing as number 3. Leading the second element was Krila Oluja No. 4, First Lieutenant Darko Belancic, the former team commentator, with No. 5 Lieutenant Denis Zivalic following him. despite the short training time, the team already put on some crowd favorite maneuvers, like this synchronized stall turn. And the formation tail slide called Blanca, unique in the world. The team takes its name, Wings of Storm, or Krila Oluje, from the final major operation of the Croatian Independence War of 1995, Storm. Also included in their repertoire was this inverted diamond pass, illustrating the high degree of training of Croatian Air Force pilots. And coming up, the signature formation mirror called Dia, named after the first, and so far only, female pilot of the team, Diana Dobosh. An enthusiastic crowd deservedly cheered the pilots to thank them for their remarkable performance. The final act of the show was the Croatian Air Force's main fighter, the MiG-21, the legendary Cold War interceptor built by Mika Jangurovic in the Soviet Union. The Croatian Air Force operates 12 upgraded MiG-21s from Zagreb, 7 of which are refurbished Croatian MiGs. The upgrade was performed by the Ukrainian company Ukrpets Export. On Saturday, the audience could admire the demonstration of Lieutenant Colonel Zilko Ninic, CEO of the Croatian Air Force's fighter squadron, and the specially painted Očkica. Well, on Sunday, he flew a regular MiG-21 UMD. With the MiG-21, we conclude this report of the entertaining Croatian International Airshow Varazdin. The 2016 airshow will be held on the 16th and 17th of July.